Let's look at a bit complex example. Over here we have a bullet which is traveling horizontally, okay? This bullet hits this stationary block, and what we have to find is the distance that this block travels, okay? Obviously this bullet is moving, so it is having some kinetic energy, right? When it hits this block, this kinetic energy is transferred onto this guy, and due to that it moves to a certain distance until that energy is lost. Okay, how is it lost? You have a friction in here, okay? So that energy is basically converted into the work done by friction. Okay, so we are supposed to find out what is the distance that this block travels due to the impact of this bullet. Okay, it is also given to us that the bullet gets embedded. Okay, so after the impact the bullet gets embedded, therefore they both travel with a common velocity. Okay, it is essentially a plastic collision, okay, a completely plastic kind of an impact. So what you have is your E is equal to 0, okay? Your VA dash is equal to VB dash, and they both together have a common final velocity after impact, okay, due to this plastic collision. Okay, so let's see how we are going to proceed in this kind of a problem. Just understand one thing. Generally, when we have impacts, there is some kinetic energy which is lost. Okay, unless you have a completely elastic collision, there is some kinetic energy that is always lost. So maybe some heat is generated and the energy is lost in the form of heat. So you cannot apply your work energy principle directly between these two points. Okay, between A, where your bullet has a velocity of 20 meter per second and your block has a velocity of 0, and point B, where both of these two guys have a velocity of V. Okay, you cannot do that because some energy is lost. What you have to do rather is you have to find out what is the velocity with which this combination of block and bullet system moves, and then you apply your work energy principle so that you find out the work done by your friction. Okay, your work done by friction is going to be equal to change in kinetic energy from here to here. Okay, so let us find out what is this common velocity with which these two guys move. What do we have for that? We have our principle of conservation of momentum. Okay, my principle of conservation of momentum is applicable when external forces are zero, or rather sum of external forces is zero. Only then you can apply your principle of conservation of momentum, because what we have is mv1 plus the impulse, which is fdt, is responsible to the new momentum, okay, is responsible for your change in velocity, right? So if I have one guy who is moving with v1, and this is the impulse on that particular guy, and because of that his momentum becomes this, and I have another guy who is m2 and he is moving with v2, and if I have same impulse but in opposite sense acting on it, so if I have minus fdt, and due to this its momentum changes to m2 v2 dash, let's say, and this guy changes to, let's say, v1 dash, then when we add these two equations, what we get is m1 v1 plus m2 v2 is equal to m1 v1 dash plus m2 v2 dash. Okay, this is my principle of conservation of energy, applicable only when the sum of forces, sum of external forces acting on the system, acting on both of these two guys together, is zero. Okay, so generally what happens is if you have a block like